Hello world and explorers. Let's continue our little view into convolutional neural networks. And today we're going to look at a convolution and how we can do a convolution, how we use filters, and how we can use different filters to display different data. And in a convolutional neural network, you take an image, you run a bunch of filter on this image, get a lot of different data from this image, and then you take more steps to hone this data in to get your actual result, and then you do a backwards computation in order to find better filters for each stage to get you closer to the real result of your data set, depending on your training. So let's look at how we can apply a filter on an image and see what different results we get from that. So if we start to look into my main method here, it's pretty simple. I read an image, I get the width and height of that image, I get all the raw pixels from this black and white image, and we can look at the image. It's me, fine picture of me from New Year's Eve a few years back. So I take this black and white image, and then I apply a filter on it. And we can look at these different filter I want to try to apply to it. We have a top filter, top. And this will look for edges from the top. So whenever it sees an edge that goes from you have something that have a lower pixel value, and then you get a higher pixel value. Then this higher pixel value, if it's from the top counted a value that you have a higher value further down, then this filter will trigger. And then we have a bottom filter that would trigger the other way around. So if we have pixels with a higher pixel value on the top, they will get more affected by this filter and give a higher value out. And if we have higher pixels below, then this filter will degrade. So these filter uses plus one to give you more of those pixels and minus one to give you less of those pixels, and then we have a neutral line in the middle to say that these don't account to the current score, and this will give us the edges on the top side or counted from the bottom. And then we can have a filter from left to right and one from right to left. And then we have the corners, left bottom, right bottom, left top, and right top. And then I just have this little nifty function that goes through each of these filters and applies them and gives it a separate name, a separate output name. So that's the main method. And this write conv file isn't that interesting. It actually just calls convolution with the filter and then writes out the new buffered array. So this is not much to go into. It's standard way of reading and writing image data if you have pure byte array data. So let's go into the convolution. This is the bulk worker, but it's also very simple. I just create a new image, I set all the image values to zero, and then I apply this 3x3 filter on this old image and I get a new image back, and then I return that. So this function doesn't do that much either. So let's go into the function that is the meat of the matter, that does the most of it. And this is also quite simple. All these small parts are quite simple. We have a value that we sum up for how much the current 3x3 square in our window will affect the output. So remember, we talked that we had a window that we went through the image and showed the window through the image, and this window, it generated an output image. Depending on the filter you applied to this image, you would get a specific result out from that image on that spot. And by applying different filters, you could get different output images. So applying a filter is pretty much just doing a dot multiplication on the matrix. And to simplify it even more, you just multiply the filter data on a specific position with the same position on the image that this filter is over. So if we have a 3x3 over a 3x3 image, then the first pixel position and the first position of the filter will be multiplied. Then we take the second position of the image, the second position of the filter, and multiply those. And those multiplications we add together. And then we do the same with the third and add that together, the fourth and add that together, and so on. And then we get a sum. And in my case, I divide this sum by 9 and also round it up in order to show it in an image in a good way. So we get some image data out that looks reasonable. And so this little for loop I have here, I actually take the current position in the image, X and Y, and I use them to calculate the image position. So I go through all Y's in the filter and all X's in the filter. I will add the current Y value to the current filter value Y, because that's the incrementer that's inside of this window. And that is then multiplied with the image width to get the current row that we are looking at. And then I will take the image X value as an offset, and then add the filter X value in order to get the current image position that I want to multiply. And then we look at the filter. That's much easier. That's just the filter Y position times 3 to get the current row, and then add the current filter X value. And then we go down to the last row here. Here I just look for the current image position to change. And to make it easy for myself, I kept the image ratio and the image size the same. But in my case, this filter, because it has a stride of 1 and a width of 3, I actually will get a result that is 2 pixels smaller, both in the Y and X axles. And to compensate by that, I move the image 1 pixel in and 1 pixel down in order to get the image centered. So this means that I will have a row of black pixels around the image. But I thought that that was a good trade-off. I didn't want to change the size of the image because, yeah, that would make this a little bit harder. And I think it's much easier to see where the different pixels end up if we keep the ratio. So now I think I have pretty much explained all the code that goes into this. So let's look at the result. So I will bring up my result folder here. So let's look at the different images. So this image here, this is an image filtered from the bottom up. Here we can see that it found edges by my chin here. It also found some edges in my hair and so on, but we can't see much of the edges in the background. And if we look at this that goes from the left, we actually see the edges on this cupboard up here, and we see some edges on the chin and so on, but we don't see so much edges down here, or as sharp edges. And then we have left bottom, then we will get some edges in the tongue here and the glasses. And if we do the left top, we will get a different kind of edges. So all these images together will get paint a picture of the different edges that goes into my face. And then we would take that one layer further and make predictions on how much these kind of edges actually will be a factor of how we find out if this is a image of me or not. And these layers and these filters are very simple. I wanted to keep it simple in order to describe it. But in the case of a real convolutional neural network, these layers will actually be computed, and well, the computer will find most of these layers that goes in the separate positions of the neural network. And this is what makes this method very interesting to look into. And I hope that you found this video instructive, and that you have a little bit more insight into how a neural network find different attributes of an image. And I learned best by actually writing code and looking into how different things works in code. If you learn in a different way, then please tell me, and we can keep a discussion in the comments below. So I really hope to hear from you, and I hope to see you in the next video.